Na moja kwa moja basi nakupeleka hadi nyumbani kwake Jaji mkuu mteule David Maraga ili aweze kutupatia hisia zake kuhusiana na uteuzi wake.
After Parliament approves the name, that is after the GSC talks to the President, and then Parliament approves the name, maybe in your office, the first 60 days in your office, what do you intend to do as the new Chief Justice of the Republic of Kenya?
I would rather we hold that because, you, first of all, you know, there's a process. I don't want to speak like I'm already a CJ, because there's the process to go through Parliament. There's a process the President has to forward the name. And once that is done, I will be able to talk to you and tell you what my vision is for the judiciary. Yes.
But of course, when you appeared before the GSC, there were some issues that you had raised regarding some of the cases that you handled. Maybe do you have any regrets for the cases that you have handled so far as we speak?
Regrets?
Yes.
No, I have no regrets. I mean, there are cases I've done, and I mean, I've done in good faith. Where I've made a mistake, the Court of Appeal, I mean, the higher court has corrected me, and that's the way things are done. So I have no problem about that.
I can remember in 2012 we saw the Law Society of Kenya coming up and saying that they have a petition saying that you as the as Justice Maraga, you have some cases to answer in terms of corruption. Is it true? But although you were cleared, how what do you do? What's your reaction on that?
You mean the answer was given in the media, the what the vetting board cleared me. And I mean the answer was there in the media. Yeah, so that is not anything to worry about. I am happy to serve the Kenyans, and I want to serve the Kenyans. Yeah, so let's first of all get the process completed, and then we'll talk. I'll give you my vision for the judiciary if that is done. Yes.
Okay, I think I understand the fact that you're hesitant on preempting what we will do when you enter the office, but maybe what are some of the key areas that...
The key area, the judiciary, what the judiciary does is hearing cases.
Yes.
Hearing cases. Service delivery to the litigants, service delivery to Kenyans. That is the key area that I will address, and I'm sure it is a key area. Anybody going to that office will address. If he doesn't address that, then you don't know what you're doing. Yes.
So in your view, what maybe made you stand out compared to the other people? Because there is a score that every country, every applicant received, and clearly you are the most qualified of them. What do you think is that unique thing that you brought to the table for that?
That I can't answer. That is for the ask the chair of the chairs, because they are the ones who discuss that.
Okay.
Yes.
So do you expect any hurdles in the next stage?
Do I expect then?
Any hurdles in the next stage in the parliamentary process and all that?
I don't know. Mm-hmm. I honestly don't know, because you see the process. I didn't know I was going to go through this first process.
Yeah.
So I don't know whether I'm going through the next process. So let's hold it. And until we get there.
Chief Justice William Mutunga, at the retirement, has left a very high legacy. Do you feel that as a challenge for you coming into a judiciary that is on the face of transforming? You are part of it.
Chief Justice Mutunga has, as you have said, yes, left. A mark. Yes, we are part of the transformation framework. So we'll just carry on from where he left, and we carry on. Yeah, you know, it is not one person. It's in the entire team of the judiciary, from the lowest to the highest. So I don't see any problem in that.
You being in the judiciary all these years, can you maybe give us a point of what has been ailing the judiciary?
Let's talk about that later, please. Let's talk about the some of those things. As I told you, I mean, if I'm picked, I will invite you myself, and I give you my vision. Yeah.